Hello, this is Johnny, and in this video I'm going to create a mouse-controlled third-person camera just like this with only a few lines of code. If you watched the previous video in the series, I've already set up the character with animations. I also went ahead and created an environment for us to play with. It's just a few primitive cube meshes with static bodies. And the floor has a shader material with a visual shader and a tile effect. And this is just a grid texture I made in Photoshop. Just so you know, this whole project will be available on GitHub for free after I'm done with the tutorials. So now I'm gonna go to our player scene that we created in our previous tutorial and add a new spatial node, which is going to be the root of our camera. I'm gonna call it cam root. Then I'm gonna add another spatial node as a child of the cam root and another spatial node as a child of that. Now I'm gonna add a built-in clip camera class, which is a camera with collisions, so that it doesn't go through other physics bodies. This here is an amazing class which reduces a lot of work for us. Previously, if we wanted to make a camera that doesn't go through walls and comes closer to the player if it hits the wall, we needed to write a lot of code to check for the collisions and all those behaviors. But the clip camera class does that all by itself. We only need to rotate and reposition it a little far away from the player like this. So now I'm gonna rename the camera and then rename the child of the root as H for horizontal and its child as V for vertical. I'm gonna move the V node over the player's head like this. I'm gonna press Ctrl 2 to get the camera view. In the code, we need to rotate the H node on its Y axis when the mouse is moved horizontally, and we're gonna rotate the V node on its X axis when the mouse is moved vertically. And that's basically all the work we need to do. I don't know if anyone has ever made this kind of system before, but I'm just gonna call this the HV parenting system. So now I'm gonna add a new script on the cam root node and call it camera.gd. I'm gonna create a new variable called cam.h, which is going to determine the horizontal movement of our camera. In the ready method, I'm gonna add an exception in our clipped camera for our player object, which is actually the parent of this node. This ensures that the camera does not collide with the player. In the input method, I'm gonna check for the mouse motion with the input event mouse motion and increase the value of cam.h by the negative of event relative x. If we don't use negative, the horizontal rotation of our camera is going to be inversed. In the physics process method, I'm gonna reference the h node and assign the value of cam.h to its y-axis rotation. So let's just play the scene by pressing F5. So everything seems to work. Now we're just gonna need to create a vertical movement and also get rid of the mouse cursor. So I'm gonna press F8 to stop running this. Now I'm gonna create another variable called cam.v and increase it with event relative y. And in the physics process, we're gonna reference the v node and modify its x rotation with the cam.v. Also, in the ready method, I'm gonna set the mouse mode to captured so that the cursor is hidden when we run. Let's just see how it is right now. So it seems to work fine. Now what we need to do is modify the sensitivity, create some acceleration, and restrict the vertical movement so that it doesn't go like this. So I'm gonna introduce some new variables. Cam V max and cam V min to restrict the vertical movement upwards and downwards. Also, other variables for horizontal and vertical sensitivity and acceleration. I'm gonna multiply the H sensitivity with event relative X and V sensitivity with event relative Y. I'm also gonna lerp the rotation. I'm gonna press Ctrl and click on this to show you the docs. Now, what lerp does is, it linearly interpolates between two values with a given weight. The weight is the rate of change with time from argument 1 to argument 2, which is essentially our acceleration. I'm gonna set the first argument as current value and the second argument as the target value for both the horizontal and vertical movements. For the weight, I'm gonna multiply delta with acceleration. I'm also going to use clamp method to limit the cam.v with minimum and maximum. This ensures the restriction of camera's upward and downward movements. If the value of the first argument goes over the maximum value, it returns the maximum value, and if it goes under the minimum value, it returns the minimum. I'm going to assign 0.1 to the sensitivity, 10 to the acceleration, and set the maximum and minimum as 75 and negative 55 respectively, which are in degrees, as we are assigning them to the degree value of our horizontal and vertical rotation. I found that these values work fine for me, but you can play around with them to get the behavior you want. So now I'm gonna run this. And this is perfect. I'm also gonna move the player beside a wall to show you the work of clipped camera. As you can see, the camera is coming closer to the player if it collides with the wall. But if you notice, for a split second we can see the other side of the wall. I fixed this by setting the process mode of the camera from physics to idle. And now it works perfectly. You can also play around with the other values of the clipped camera class. All the properties are pretty straightforward. So that's it for this video. See you in the next one.